So, the first question goes, ma'am, a tough preposition, but how do we equip parents to envisage a school within home? How do we go about this, ma'am?
Okay, so a teacher, when a mother becomes a teacher, it is not a good thing. Children don't like that, first of all. So if anyone who wants to homeschool their children, first thing they should keep in mind that they cannot become teachers of their children. They cannot replicate school at home. That is what John Holt, one of the greatest thought leaders in alternative education, has said. But a parent can be a role model to their children, just like the teachers are in their school. And it is even a bigger responsibility. Why? Because in school, children don't just learn from their teachers, they learn from each other. And it is not necessarily that what they see is something that they follow blindly. But at home, they think their mom or their dad are role models. Till the age of 13 or 14 maybe, then they understand that this mom and dad, though they preached us all through the life, they know very little. They themselves know very little. So I would say, if a parent want to start homeschooling, first off, it is very, very important. I tell this to each and every parent that come to me, that become a better person. And even for teachers, I would say, if you want to become a better teacher, you have to become a better person. You can't become a good educator if you are not. So for every parent, I think personal development is very important even before they start homeschooling, because their weaknesses are influencing their children's education when they start home education. So I would suggest they would focus on personal development.
Definitely, ma'am. When we talk about children in school, we all understand that teachers can manage 40 children together.
Yeah.
But for parents to manage one single child, to bring that child under their control or under their periphery, you know, of handling, it's so difficult, you know. That is what we, the mainstream teachers, we face difficulties when parents come and tell us, you know, that they are unable to manage them. So yes. Definitely parents need to understand it and become a better person. Ma'am, the second question goes, is homeschooling an efficient path to bring empowerment and transformation in education?
No. I think homeschooling is a tool. It's more important how you use this tool. Just like I would say money or intelligence, for that matter, they are the tools. If you use intelligence in a good way, you benefit. But there are cases when you don't use this intelligence for good things, then you don't benefit. So in the same way, if you use homeschooling tool in an effective way, it definitely helps in empowerment and transformation at a bigger level. But it is not always the case, because you all are qualified as teachers. You have spent years to become teachers, educators. Parents who homeschool, they don't need any qualification. Anybody can start homeschooling any day. And that will not lead to any kind of empowerment and transformation. So homeschooling per se is not the sure shot path for empowerment or transformation, but homeschooling has lot of potential to empower and transform the children, I would say.
But I'm sure, ma'am, you would agree that in today's scenario where both the parents are working, How do the parents manage to it, you know, because ultimately it happens either the parent has to have the willingness to sacrifice their career or their ambitions. It is only then that they could really think of becoming a good teacher at home or to homeschool their children, isn't it?
I would say sometimes dreams are more important than our ambitions or career. Like in my case, I'm not an ambitious person, but I have big dreams. And one of those dreams was staying 24/7 with our daughters, learning with them, exploring life with them. That was one of the dreams that became true. And when both the parents are ambitious, which is okay, which is fine. Yes. I don't think they should even think of homeschooling, because it's like a school without teacher, without facilitator, a class without facilitator. So I don't think that is advisable.
Exactly, ma'am. Exactly. Yeah. Ma'am, the third question goes, how does one inculcate the social skills in learners in homeschooling?
That's a very good question. This is one of the biggest disadvantage of homeschooling. Even if homeschooling parents are saying that no, our children are interacting with the world, sometimes that is their favorite sentence, instead of interacting with 40 children in a class, they are interacting with the world. But let me tell you, this sentence are self-pleasing sentences, because they are doing homeschooling, they don't want to feel negative. If you see the facts, homeschooling is the one of the threats of homeschooling is that they have lesser opportunities for developing social skills. But even in school, the children who are quiet, who are introvert, who have social anxiety, school is not a place where that is taken care of. Again, such children have different needs, and neither the school nor a homeschool will take care of these needs per se. But at least in homeschooling, we are aware of our children's needs, and then we can take some action. Like I started Indian Association of Homeschoolers and a Mumbai chapter just because I didn't want my children to feel lonely. So that is something I did, and that worked so fantastically that has become a movement now. Homeschooling has become a movement. So a small action that you take to address this lack of opportunities can just benefit your children also, and can benefit others also. So you have to thoughtfully address that in homeschooling. Yes.
Ma'am, I would like to say here that the mainstream schools are stressing a lot on experiential learning these days.
Yes.
And I feel that children who are doing homeschooling, it is already helping them to learn experientially in an experiential manner at a comfortable pace and in a free environment.
Yes.
So I think the social skills definitely do, somewhere or the other, they do come in.
Yes.
Next question, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. With admission forms asking for previous records or certificates, it's a technical issue, ma'am. How did you manage to move on without them from Malvika and Radha? Your daughter, how was it?
I have a very interesting answer to this. Malvika, when she went to MIT, she didn't know anything in chemistry or biology. Two subjects, definitely nothing. I mean, she didn't know what is proton, what is neutron, and what is electron. At MIT, these subjects are mandatory. You have to give exams in these subjects, and again, it is at advanced level. So everyone was worrying, how would they face, you know, this college education. And after 6 months, I got a call from Malvika. Malvika said, "Mama, so we are Marathi people, so I will just say it in Hindi." Yeah. She said, "Mama, ऐसे कैसे हो गया यार? So I said, what happened, Malvika? But mama, you said this is something that I cannot imagine. ऐसे ऐसे हो ही नहीं सकता है यार. So I said, what happened? But I could sense that there's nothing to worry. She was little excited only. She said, mama, मुझे केमिस्ट्री में A plus मिल गया. But ये कैसे हो सकता है यार? So I think Malvika or Radha were not admitted to colleges to become successful. They were admitted to college because they were successful. They were successful learners, and that is what Malvika proved by getting A plus in chemistry in first semester in first year. So they got admitted on the basis of what they did. Their portfolio included the storybooks that they read, the projects that they completed, the something that they did just for themselves, just time pass, pastime, just as a pastime. Everything that they did in 4, 5, whatever years, but happiness or self-exploration was the greatest purpose that colleges could see in that portfolio. Is my opinion, they were self learners. Yeah, there were no appointed teachers. Yes. So that was very challenging, and I think colleges thought that. And I thought colleges thought that a child who can learn on their own so much. Can learn easily with the help of teachers in the college, whatever subjects they are. So I think on that basis they got admitted.
They were self-learners, and at the same time they had charted their own path of learning, ma'am. That is what I would say to this.
Yes, absolutely.
Ma'am, the next question. What are the advantages of homeschooling as compared to mainstream schooling?
The way we discussed the flow of this or focus of this session was about individual needs of the child. In school, it is not really possible to take care of those individual needs. But in homeschooling, it is definitely possible to see what is the pace of your child, what is the passion of your child, what is the subject that he or she doesn't like. What is the way that he or she wants to learn a particular subject? When do they want to learn? So I'm talking about the individual need, individual pace of learning, individual style of learning. And that is something that we can provide in homeschooling. And that is the greatest benefit, because the entire childhood, we just really trade, our children trade for getting education in school. And they are poor children. They don't even understand that is not the best way they can, you know, they can, their individual needs are met. It is not a flaw, but it is a limitation of the system. I understand. But every child gets into a school with a hope of becoming a good person, big person, but that doesn't happen. I mean, school is not a best place to encourage their dreams and their hopes. So I think homeschooling can do that, is the biggest advantage. Apart from that, my favorite is that many a times family sees each other only on a dinner table, but homeschooling is the only way of living together. How many years? Just 5 years we were together, but those years are like golden years of my life. Because now Malvika is in her own world, Radha is in her own world, but 24/7 we learned, we grew together. So family togetherness is one of the advantages of homeschooling.
Thank you, ma'am. Yes. Now